Hi everyone, this is the results of the last voting session. Sorry, this took a little bit longer for me to get to. I was delayed a little bit by my little 24-hour live stream event, but that's neither here nor there. So the question was, do we attack the forces that approach Dyrrhachium, or do we wait? So we had 10 votes to attack and 12 votes to wait. So it looks like patience wins the day. Now I'm also going to bring up the top comment that had the most little thumbs up votes from your fellow senators. This is by Machine3589, and I'll just post it right here for you to read at your leisure. Very well done. I love this in-character stuff. It's pretty great. It really gets me pumped up to play the game. So thank you very much for watching. And I'll see you in the game. Hello everyone and welcome back to Let's Interactively Play Roma Surrectum 2. So I tallied up the votes and narrowly the people who supported defense or at least waiting voted the ones who said attack right away. Some people said to wait just in case, you know, we're better suited to defensive positions. Some people said wait till we get reinforcements. Some people said wait until we get a spy out and figure out this area a little bit better. Either way, we're gonna wait. That will be that. That was it for this turn, so I'm going to press the enter turn button, and I'll get back to you at the top of the next turn. Alright, top of the turn, we're going to have censors elections pretty soon, but, very interesting, they have a few more forces up here by Edessa, but they didn't move to attack us. I think because they know that we have them outclassed so far. So this is the makeup of their men. Wow, some veterans here, but nothing too scary, honestly. And this is going to be more than enough for us to bring over our men. We're going to have them set up right there. Put them right there. We're going to... Let's see here. Who would be completely useless? These skirmishers are pretty handy, but we don't need this many, especially if we're going to be defensive. So I think we're going to do something like that. There we go. And we're going to just disband this unit here. We don't really need it, and we can recruit a bloody ton of them. So, and where's my spy? There he is. So, let's first take a closer look at what's going on over here in Edessa. Not much, and now let's send him further inland. I think further inland is best. They seem to be coming from this direction. I still have all these other reports, but I really want to see what the spy can see. Alright, here's one border. Is there a road that we can follow? Well, there's a road down here. Uh-huh, there's Pella. Pretty big. Pretty well developed. Looks like... No. Thessalonike. Another road down here. The Macedonians look pretty powerful. Pharsalus. And there's the border to Greece there. So now we have at least a better idea as to their landmass. I think I can have our spy sneak around down this way next turn. I don't know whether I want to attack them yet. We can win, there's no question. It's just, they're not bold enough to attack us. So, of course, they could be raiding our crops. And that is the successor. I'll think about it. Let's finish off with the end of turn report. Still made a profit. Making still almost about 30,000 denarii a turn. Publius Cornelius Scipio is now a former K-Store. Lucius Vibenus Attalus, who is our governor of Tarentum, he is now our Curule Edile? Building manager, pretty much. Quintus Cecilius Metellus is now our K-Store. Wow, he has quite a bit of influence and management skill. Let's see here. Gaius Tarentus Vero is also a case store. Oh. Alright, the one in charge of Dyrrachium. Let's see here. Large client networks, medium client networks, medium estates. So pretty much, those are all just saying that these individuals are getting bigger estates, better influence, more political clout. We have Publius Cornelius Scipio has himself an intrepid explorer now, who joined them during the siege of Genoa. And we have an honest advisor for Sextus Fabius Maximus, who is in charge of Cannae. Looks like he'll need it because he has zero influence. Okay. And of course, we have our construction that has been completed. And our recruitment report. We're going to keep those men there. Our noble cavalry can also stay there. And we have an assassin. That's right. I forgot that I recruited an assassin for fun. Who should we go after? Well, let's go after our most hated enemy, Carthage. We're going to put that assassin on this boat. Garden. Yeah. Unfortunately, he's not going to... Can he get there in time? Maybe. Oh, maybe. Let's go for it. Oh, no. Alright, well, we'll drop him off there next time. It should still be pretty safe. See if our spy and assassin can't get something done. Well, a 75% chance to... Wow. To infiltrate Carthage. That's tempting. That is extremely tempting. But, I'd rather have a better odds, frankly. Ooh, wow, they have elephants. Of course, I don't know if I can ever get better odds. He only has one subterfuge.
At your service.
Let's have him go after this army. It's a smaller force. It'll give him some experience, maybe? Yes! Good! Excellent! He's now sneakier. He succeeded, and now that's a 93% chance. That's an excellent chance of infiltrating. So we're gonna go down here still. These towns don't look like they have any walls. Is it just me, or do they have no walls?
On my way.
You'd think we'd be able to see walls. They don't have any walls. My goodness, that would be so easy to raid. I'm formulating ideas in my head. I sure am. Especially with this army here. Problem is I don't know if garrison... Well, without any walls, I can attack right away, so a garrison script wouldn't fire off. I'm wondering if I should move this army over to Lily Bomb. And then that's within better striking distance. And it could still come out. Let me just give this a quick little quick save. Because, I mean, my men would know whether they had range or not. No, I'd be stuck in the middle of the ocean. I don't know if I'm crazy about that. Honestly. No, we're gonna wait. I'm gonna need to have, like, an invasion force, which is, like, more than just one army, so... You can go back there, ship. You guys... can just stick around there. Guard, Carolise's port. Okay. Well, I'm going to keep on thinking and planning, and I'll get back to you. Well, one thing I know we can definitely handle is some of these pirates here. A good practice. They have three Byrenes, and I have four Byrenes, led by an experienced admiral. Hopefully we'll succeed. Clear victory. Excellent. That is fantastic news. You can go back here, and you all can be retrained in Masana. And in Region. Totally worth it. Good. Alright, so here's my thinking. I have three fronts right now. I have a northern front, which is about to be resolved, but still, some men, a large force, will have to be posted up here just to make sure these barbarians don't get any ideas of invading. Alright? I have another front here in Dyrrachium. Well defended area. And sure, the Macedonians are a pest, and we are at war with them. But they have a lot of large cities, and plus, I believe they're at war. Oh, I hope they're at war with the Greeks. They are at war, no, only with us. That is a little trickier. I might have to go ahead and attack them there. But what I really want to do is get Carthage off my back. And I really want to raid some of their African towns significantly. So if I had two stacks here, and then once the main fight or invasion starts, start ferrying in reinforcements from time to time, have a strong naval presence around here, I think we could crush Carthage pretty well. But I can't do all that focus and also focus on Dyrrhachium. So I think we're going to focus on one enemy at a time, and we're going to keep on developing Rome in the meantime. So as much as I want to, I'm not going to attack. They're going to have to spend so many resources in trying to take Dyrrhachium. It will be immense. It'll be amazing. And I'd suffer so many casualties. See, the reason why I don't want... See, I'm pondering this over my head, and I want you to realize that there's a reason for me deciding to continue to wait. Mostly due to the fact that... Okay, I go out there, I attack them, right? Let's say I lose 1,000 men. Well, now I'm going to have to spend all that time losing those 1,000 men and recruiting them and retraining them and sending them back over to Dyrrhachium. Some of them are mercenaries that I can't actually recruit. So I'd rather have a nice full stack in Dyrrhachium, have them have to spend so many resources and try to assault the city, and probably even fail. So, if anything, maybe I'll slowly start replacing, say, Peltast units with heavy infantry, and then that will just be the final nail in the coffin, and Dyrrhachium hopefully will not fall. But we're going to focus on Carthage. That's the plan. Alright, so if I want to start building a second legion, we have to have a good foundation of cohorts. So we're going to recruit all the cohorts that we can. Cohorts that we can. Unfortunately, we only have three areas in which we can do so. So that is less good. I know I can construct buildings and barracks and that type of thing, but I want it to come naturally of its own course once I'm done building the other buildings, and I'm not really in that much of a rush or at a crisis point, so why rush the LP? Besides, for those of you who don't know, I do have a 12 turns per year mod going on, so I should be okay. Well, that's about it for heavy troops. I'm going to start putting some money into buildings. I'll get back to you. Okay, still a ton of construction. Let's see if there's anything of note. River ports in Roma. Well, still being built. Let's see here. A market in Dyrrhachium. Trade expedition in Emporia. Shrine of Ceres. A little bit of sharecrop mining. Wine trade in Illyria, Lily Balm, Crotona has some guard posts, no really new buildings, just kind of more the same, keeping the infrastructure strong and building and developing. We still have a ton of money, so we're going to do something about that, I think. Alright, one last thing I'm going to do is, before I end the turn, Admiral Lucas here. Lucius, actually, sir, he has four command. He's an amazing commander, so we're going to actually give him a fleet. So we're going to head up to Roma. We have just enough movement to dock it. And we're going to recruit a... Never mind. I was going to recruit a trireme, but then I realized it takes one per turn. So we need men more than we need ships. So instead... Can you make it to Capua? No, you can't. Damn. Well... We're just going to have to wait, then. And I'll recruit Navy next turn. I'll have the money. I'm going to just check one more thing. I'm going to just check for mercenary units. Tarentine Cavalry. That's not really going to be all that useful. How about in Cannae? Some more Greek slingers. Those could be handy. Okay, that's good to keep in mind. Capua? Anything there? Special? More slingers, Tarantine cavalry, Samnite pedetes. Samnites, eh? I guess those would work. Those might be better than Acontisti. And what do we have in Rome? What can we recruit in Rome? Medium cavalry. Alright. Well, I have the money. Might as well do it. Alright. You go back to Capua. You are making your butt over to Dyrrhachium. And you're going to replace a Peltast unit. I think that'll be it. I'm just a little curious. Just a little curious as to... Whoa. Hello. Okay, we're going to keep these mercenaries as an emergency basis. Who knows if the Greeks in Syracuse are going to start building up, or if the Carthages manage to have some sort of crazy invasion that I can't prepare for. So, I'm really in no rush. I'm in control, so I'm happy.